Namaste. Welcome to ARPIT, conducted by Indian Institute of Technology, Delhi. I am Manoj Kumar, scientist E INFLIBNET Center from Gandhinagar, Gujarat. I'll be talking about the importance of an institute which has been established by University Grant Commission as Information and Library Network Center. The name is derived from the first three letters of each word: library, information, and network. INFLIBNET is focused on library-related activities, but it does not stop doing its activities limited to only library. In the next 30 minutes, you will come across with various activities which is done by INFLIBNET to enhance the quality of higher education in the country. INFLIBNET is continuously striving its force and mission and activities as well as services to reach the quality in research in the higher education sector. And I will be talking about INFLIBNET, which is headed by Professor J.P. Singh Jurel, the director, and these slides are taken from our various activities, and I acknowledge each of the scientists who head the projects in the center. So we started year 1991 as a registered society in 96 under UGC. 91 it was a project under IUCA. In 96 it's a society registered under UGC as a special inter-university center for library professionals. And the journey will take you what is happening in the library field. The physical collection which was kept in the library is been liberated and it has moved to the digital world with the digital content. Each and every library in the country resources and which is the reservoir of information, this is to be shared across other libraries. So the major objective of INFLIBNET is to connect this library, that is to network in the technical term, and share or disseminate the information available in each library, which may not be affordable for other institutions. So let me start with where we are located. INFLIBNET is not just a library network. It is something more than that, and we provide lot of other support, especially the Ministry of HRD for its ranking, for the quality parameter, for different sorts of model, including the latest one, which provides plagiarism detection software to 1,000 plus universities and institutions in the country. This tree will show you, which is on the slide, various activities. I am putting all the activities together. We started with library automation. So the library automation INFLIBNET Center has developed a software called SOL. SOL stands for Software for University Libraries, but it has adopted all the standards available in library domain across the world. That is the global standards being taken for designing and developing this library automation package called SOL. So instead of calling it as a library software for university libraries, we would like to call it as library software for universal libraries, whether it is a college library, a school library, or other libraries. So the fundamental things to do, the fundamental modernization of activities to do in a library is nothing but automate the library. There are various activities which is going on in libraries, starting from the acquisition, cataloging, classification, and stock verification, budgeting. These are some of the modules which any library automation software is having. So SOL has a very sophisticated module for everything, and we are very proud to tell that INFLIBNET Center has almost marketed or installed 3,500 plus institutions, which also include some of the very, very major popular university such as University of Mumbai, Banaras Hindu University, BHU, and MSU Baroda, where you will see the collection itself is more than 5 lakhs onwards. And that is, we started from this library automation activities. And we started giving assistance to library automation. In our earlier 5-year plan, we have given grants to the universities to do these activities. Then from there onwards, we started providing the resources. So if you look at the vertical of our activities, the e-resources, how it was happening before InfliBNet. Every university spent a lot of money to buy the required resources, the demanding resources by the researcher and faculty members. And it will be available only in the university library. InfliBNet has taken this mission. Electronic journal is one of the important thing or primary resource for conducting research. So InfliBNet has formed something called consortium. In consortium means we try to put all universities together and subscribe to the electronic journals by negotiating with the publisher, which are generally international publishers. And InfliBNet Center was able to devise a model of this negotiation and bring down the price of many of the resources to the 90%. So for example, if I'm asking about Elsevier Science, subscription to Elsevier Science for one university will cost about 75 lakhs to 1 crore for collections, depending on. There are 10 to 13 collections inside Elsevier. If you take one collection also, it may be 20, 25 lakhs. So if you are going subscribing individually, 10 universities, it becomes 10 crore rupees. So what we do, InfliBNet has negotiated with Elsevier for the important collection which are required for the universities, because InfliBNet directly deal with the universities. And then we started negotiating, and we are able to bring down the cost of this pricely journal to almost half or 40% down, which are very, very expensive. Some of the journal like JSTOR, social science, etc., we are able to bring down the cost drastically down. That means with the minimum amount of money, we are able to support on electronic media by using the platform internet, by using the IP-based access, more and more universities to the resources. The research will become very easy for the researchers who can get all these articles on their fingertips. This project is called UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortium earlier. Now, this has been renamed as eShowSindhu, because consortium is being run by InfliBNet, also by Indest, by AICT. All this is, and there is a model of same consortia, which gives about 8,000 journal plus 30 lakh electronic books to colleges in a model called Enlist. So we combined Enlist, AICT, and UGC InfoNet Digital Library Consortia. Ministry combined all these consortia together, put one consortia in the country, which is called eShowSindhu. That means InfliBNet has put the effort of bringing all the resources under one umbrella, under one resource funding from Government of India. So this is how the model works in library. This is something different from what you are thinking about the use of IT in libraries. So this is a model which is basically on policy based, basically on the negotiation based, basically on the conglomeration and requirement of the universities based. As seen in picture, you can see Indus AICT, UGC InfoNet, and Enlist, which is called eShowSindhu. Now, InfliBNet is focusing on this avoiding plagiarism in researchers. This is one of the biggest menace in the country. If I am talking about the research publications, what do I mean by research publications? Research publication can be articles. Research publication can be a book. Research publication can be thesis, or it could be lecture note. So any of the academic publication, when it is bringing out by the researcher and faculty member, we find that there is an amount of copied content from other sources. To put it in a little hype and exaggerated, in country there was a time, if you submit one thesis in a university, the same thesis can be resubmitted in another university, in another region. And in the country, we don't have a mechanism to check whether this has been already submitted or not. This kind of duplication of submission of the same content, duplication of research, which is one way, wastage of national money. Second way, it is an ethical issue. It's the question of honesty of not only individual or researcher. It is a dishonor to the institutions where it is been conducted. So what is the best model to stop this kind of unethical activities? What library can do for this, or what INFLIBNET can do for this, or what can UGC or MHRD can do for this? In this contest, I would like to tell you that, friends, there was a landmark notification issued by UGC in the year 2009. The notification addressed about the submission of PhD thesis as well as the other related requirement while conducting PhD in the country when it is in a university. And I would like to highlight one of the points, clause number 17, which talks about after submission of thesis in the university, that is after award of the thesis in the university, one of the copies should go to the national repository. That becomes mandatory for the nation. And how does this help to stop plagiarism? Because the content which is created by a researcher, once it is awarded, also can be evaluated by any other person at any point of time. That's why doing research with copied content is not easy now, which will give into something called plagiarism. And I am sure that the plagiarism module or a topic is already handled here, and the consequences of plagiarism is told in that lecture, and the consequence can cause a research scholar to lose their registration if it is above certain level of plagiarized content. The same thing also may cause the job of a professional. A professor can lose their job. A vice chancellor may have to quit their job in challenge of plagiarism. So this is to be tackled. The first attempt for tackling this issue was putting all this into one place, one national portal, which is called Shodh Ganga. As you know, that Shodh stands for research in Sanskrit and Hindi. And Ganga is the holiest, largest river flowing in the subcontinent with the history and civilization of our country. So by coining these two words, Shodh one side and Ganga other side, Shodh Ganga gives an Indianized name for our repository of thesis. As on date, we have 2,40,000 plus free open access PhD thesis on the portal called Shodh Ganga. We also have a supporting project for Shodh Ganga, a supplementary project for Shodh Ganga, which is called Shodh Gangotri, where we put the abstract or we put the research proposal which is approved by the university. That means synopsis, research proposal or approved abstract can be put in the Shodh Gangotri, which need not be the full text content, which can be one page or two page, so that we will come across what research is going on in the country. All this says that how information and library network as a center is supporting the research in the country. Now, there are so many other projects which I will come across. I will just name few projects like Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, E Shodh Sindhu, Sol. In addition to that, INFLIBNET is also the academic technical collaborator for ministry to execute the project called NIRF. NIRF has given stiff competition among the higher education institutions now, whether it is engineering college, normal university, central university, or CFTI, centrally funded technical institutions. So let me tell you a figure right now, approximately, that what is our higher education system consist of in the country. This figure may slightly change if you look at the MHRD website or UGC website. But what I have is, we have about 1,030 plus universities and institutions in the country which works in higher education. This 1,030 includes central universities, state public universities, CFTIs, centrally funded technical institutions, which is about 129, 130. there are 50 odd central universities in the country, which is directly funded by the central government itself. And there are institutions like Indian Institute of Technology. So the CFTIs include IITs, IIM, NITs, NISER, IIIT, and other national institute of importance. So altogether form 130 approximately institutions. So this 1,000 include this state university, CFTI, central university, deemed university in government, deemed university in private, as well as the private universities. So some of the project in InfliBNet is focused only on the government funded universities. Like ESO Sindhu, you need to have a status in UGC called 12B. 12B is a status given to a university which are eligible for getting grants from University Grant Commission. So many of our projects are open access and free, but few are like you need to have this certificate. So many times it is felt that you need to have 12B certificate, whether it is college or university. But 12B status of UGC is not required for many of our projects. For example, Shodh Ganga is absolutely free and open access for any university. You don't need to even register. You can directly come and access these resources. Then we have ICSSR databases, which is the data sets available for statistical data available, which is part of ICSSR, which is available as a repository. You can select the repository set of data and work on it. Then in addition to we have our own repository, we conduct a regular training program and we conduct the expert, maintain the expert database. And I will come across each of this in few seconds to show you that what exactly it stands for. Now, when we created the library automation in universities, we asked the university to give their catalog, like thesis we are asking from universities. So our old project since inception is getting the catalog of each university. Every university has a catalog database. So this catalog can be merged together at a national center. So InfliBNet take this responsibility and merge all catalog together, and we call it as Union Catalog. And we have named it as Indian Catalog. In short, it is called INCAT. So Union Catalog of books, theses, serials, and videos, all are available in INCAT. If you go and search in this catalog, you will find that there are more than 1.2 crore books in this bibliographic database. Please don't take it as a full text content. It's only catalog. Catalog means it's a bibliographic information of what is available in university. So what is the advantage of this Union Catalog? When you are searching for a very rare material, you come to INCAT, Google it, give INTCAT in Google, and come there and give the title of the book. You get the all information. You can also get the university details there, the librarian details, phone number, email. Perhaps if you send a mail on a fair copy basis, they may send you the one chapter or one page or two pages, whatever policy or whatever copyright they are having, depending upon that. But this still it is working on that. So this generally work with the very, very rare books which is available in the library, which is kept separately. So that is what is called INCAT. And INCAT is a byproduct of Soul software. When we library automated, we got the catalog we merged together and put it as Indian Catalog. And this name is derived from World Catalog. It's called WorldCat. So you can get WorldCat also. That means the Union Catalog of all world, it is also available. And I was mentioning about ISO Sindhu. Now I'll take you quickly that what are the resources available here. Earlier it was UGC InfoNet. Now there are few experiment, bibliometric study we do on this. We get InfiStat. After spending a lot of money, whether the return of investment is available. This is one of the major things. How many people are using it? How many downloads are happening? Or is our publication in the universities are going after giving these resources? These kind of studies are done by InfliBNet, part of our research, and that is something called InfiStat. And even university can access to InfiStat and they can get the data, analyze the data. If they feel that this resource is not required for them, they can tell us. We'll take the resource from them and give it to somebody else. ESO Sindhu, all universities are not getting all resources. there is something called primary, core university, core 1 university, core 2 university, core 3 university. So core 1 will get almost all resources. Core 3 may not be getting all, especially the university which has established very recently, like central universities, 14, 15 central universities are there. So this university may not be getting all resources. We start with 5 resources first. That's why we take a kind of statistics and usage statistics from them, and all this study is happening on this Shodh Sindhu. This is the, what you see is the Shodh Sindhu screen, and right now directly 217 universities are using it, 91 CFTI is part of it, 3000 from colleges are directly benefiting out of this, 10,000 plus journals are available on this, 31 lakh, that means 3 million books, 3.13 million books, 31 lakh, 35,000 e-books are available for colleges. This e-book model is not available for university for the time being. Then there are 22 publishers and 4 databases, and all these are together available and e-shows Sindhu. And again, we have given an Indianized name for that, which is very popular. You can see the circle here, which marks the beneficiaries. One is the institution which is getting out of it. Second, the resources which is given. And NLIST has a special component which is designed for colleges, which has 6.18 lakh users now. It's a good number of faculty and students are using it. So, students, we are not giving direct access. All faculty members are getting in. 3,200 colleges are getting this benefit now. Colleges has to pay a minimum token amount of subscription fee. The subscription fee we generally collect to see that whether it is required or not. And surprisingly, we see that NAC has given this as a parameter. Are you getting access to NLIST? Are you using Shodh Ganga? These are the parameters now included in NAC accreditation process. So people will come to us for taking this benefit from INFLIBNET tender. So college can join anytime. Access is anywhere, anytime. No limit for the download. We treat one subscription for 200 colleges. Like IIT Delhi, we have to give one subscription under eShow Sindhu. The same one subscription we buy from publisher, give to 200 colleges. So 200 colleges treat as one university. That is the beauty of this model when it was worked out. That is what is called NLIST. Now, the byproduct is InfiStat, which is not very important to understand in detail. Like we have counterproductive statistics. You cannot trust somebody that everybody download cannot be a parameter. So we have to see that what is the download happening from publisher. And if they are telling that you have downloaded 20,000 documents in this month, we have to also have a counter complaint, which is an international standard, and SUCHI. We take this from there and we give a reminder when they are low usage for the university. Sometimes we take out the resources from the university and give it to other university if it is expensive. Then there is something called JGATE. JGATE give access to almost 50,000 journals, which is having many of them are open access also, where every article is added, and we are subscribing this. And there is a document delivery service. INFLIBNET has identified almost 26 places. So if you are looking for an article, you can use JGATE to request for that article. If IIT Delhi is having that, or JNU is having that, or Central University of Hyderabad is having that, they will send you that copy on fair copy policy. So this is happening now in JGATE. That means if you are looking for an article which is very expensive or available in some part of the country, out of these 26 centers, these 26 centers are in such a way that they are subscribing almost all resources in the country. So you will get article from that. And this is the usage of research output. If you look at it from 75 to 2017, day we started 2004 onwards, the research output, that means article published by university, has drastically gone up on this. And INFLIBNET also promote open access mode. What is open access? We should not pay for the resources. That is the concept of it. So open access is a philosophy globally promoted by the good research scholars and academician and faculty member. And in that, journals are public on open access. Contents are created and published on open access. So if you look at Shodh Ganga, is an open access repository of thesis. We have IR, it's an open access repository. Shodh Gangotri, research open access. ICSS data services, info portal, subject based. Open journal access system. These all are using open source product as well as open access content. So the content created is available free of cost for any of the academician and students in this country. This is what about Shodh Ganga statistics today, when I was just looking at it. You have that 241,255 today and 6,400 synopses. And if you look at that, this is voluntary contribution. And we would like to acknowledge the topmost 10 contributions. You come to Shodganga website, the top 10 universities are listed there. Here you can read the names: University of Calcutta, Pune University, Aligarh Muslim University, Punjab University, and University of Madras, Anna University. All these are the top contributors. Calcutta University, if you are looking at, they have 11,000 plus PhD theses on open access. It is as good as 11,000 e-books you are having, because thesis is already in the high researched content, which has been reviewed by the research supervisor and also evaluated by the expert and make changes. This could be taken as the primary source for your learning purposes. And INFLIBNET has designed another database called Vidwan Expert Database. If you are an associate professor and above, if you are a distinguished scientist, if you are an expert or award winner in particular area which is related to research and academics, you can register as an expert in our expert database. We give this name expert database as Vidwan. So you come to that, there are 25,000 Vidwans in this. The Vidwan means they must be having publications of their own. They must be having enough citations of their own. So you come to expert. If you are watching this video, or if you know somebody who is an expert, ask them to register. The registration form is available in the Vidwan website. And after Vidwan, another model arises from this. You might have already listened to something called Indian Research Information Network, IRINS, Indian Research Information Network System. All the researchers will be networked now. Information and library network job is that. The network was about technical network. Now we are talking about researcher network, academician network, university network, college network. So the network, in a sense, the researcher will have their own network, and every institution will create their profile with publications and citation and co-author network. And ministry has funded this last year. 150 institutions are already in IRINS project. And this is not for the students, but this is for the universities and the research institutions. So we create an institute research profile based on that. So we are expecting that Vidwan database, IRNI, will work in a better way to make all the researchers come in a common platform and share their research across each other. And the quality of the Indian research will go up, and it will be at par with any international research recognized country in the world. And Vidwan, who can join, which I mentioned about it, it is given that there are about 25,349 profiles now, 3,100 institutions part of it, and we have about 359,000 citation itself in the Vidwan. So we have given one screenshot here for giving example. I have taken Delhi Technical University, that is the university of our INFLIBNET governing board chairman's vice chancellor is there in Delhi Technical University. So you will see that how many public scholarly resources are there, how many publications, how many citations are there, and who has the highest researcher, who has more citation. Go to IIT Madras, you will see the beautiful network. If you click on one of the researcher, you will see who are the co-author of that, and you can go to the next researcher. This is what one thing which as an example. So this is what the research screenshot, publication count, citation count. What you see on the right side is the beautiful co-author network. You can remove the years which is listed in the left side. If you want to see who are the co-author in 2017 for this researcher, just click on 2017, you will list out all the co-author and go it. This is something called co-author network. Now, research output is one of the important parameters. How many publications your university is bringing out every year? That is a benchmark. That is the quality of an institute. And annual growth of publications and contribution of university compared to world and India's total publications. And status of national international collaboration the university is having. But you can contribute India's growth. How? You find out a researcher in your area in any other country, write a paper collaboratively that will give value not only for your institution but for the country as well. So all these are the top parameters for judging and ranking a university. So ranking, coming in top of the world, will not happen overnight. The country and the academician, the researcher, you and me and the students has to put their effort together. That's why network is important. Put the effort together to bring out the result for the nation, so that we need a kind of network, kind of resource sharing, and the kind of dissemination of information and the kind of quality publication as well. So INFLIBNET will be working on that. In addition to that, INFLIBNET also has partnered for EPG Padashala, that is UGC based syllabus for post graduation. Kindly Google EPG Padashala. You will get video lectures, almost 23,000 videos are there, which is based on PG syllabus, and there is 23,000 e-text is there. Now, because of the success of this now, this has been transferred or migrated as something called Swayam platform. That is UGC Swayam is there. AICT, UGC and other institution has joined together to provide video lectures and courses. You can attend a course offered by MOOC, and INFLIBNET works in the background for the technical help for MOOC. We also have, personally, I have a module which is called Research Ethics module, which is running right now in Swayam platform. And you can see almost videos related to plagiarism, ethics, mixed conduct, reference management tool, whatever the other faculty talked about plagiarism, you will see a live example of everything. And we have the DTH channel on higher education. 32 DTH channels are there, which is called Swayam Prabha. And Vidya Mitra has 66,000 videos, which has NPTEL videos, their text, then the open education repository content. And we received the best OER award in the year 2018. And we have done, after NIRF, ARIA ranking, NAC research output data analysis is done by us. NCT, that is teacher education, accreditation management is developed by technically by our team. ENBA is now online accreditation from NBA course. NBA, National Board of Accreditation. And we have two special convention, Planner and Caliber, where we request, Planner is for Northeast region, and Caliber is for international convention, where we discuss all issues. And from there, it emerges a model. If you have an idea how we can improve the quality of education and research in the country, come to one of our conference, present a paper, give it to us. We will very seriously look into that. This is how ENLIST came. College has a huge demand for getting resources when universities are getting. And the ENLIST model came from one of these conferences called Caliber. And this is human research. If you look at our number of training, we have trained about 762 programs, 59,000, that is 60,000. And recently, last August, we have conducted 5 regional program for plagiarism detection system software, how to use, and the ethics to be followed in various part of the country like Chandigarh, IIM Calcutta, Nehu Shillong, Kusat Cochin, as well as Bombay, MGM University of Health Sciences, Navi Mumbai. We keep on doing this training program for the benefit of the pupil, how best you can use it. In addition, INFLIBNET maintains UGC website. If you are applying for scholarship, the backend server is located at Gandhinagar INFLIBNET. So we have UGC website. We also help the university, like Central University portal for many universities. Academic job portal, ESAT, Distant Education Bureau, grievances for UGC, all this e-governance project now is given to INFLIBNET. The technical service we provide, study in India, national testing agencies, design, role and development, FS scan, that Foodscape Safety Knowledge Network scan, and many of the ministries project, technically we give technical expertise. And this is about ARIA when it was released, and you can read some of the quotations here from the former Prime Minister and as well as Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. These are some of the words we focus, like innovation is born out of cultural excellence. This excellence is a process when I'm talking as individual, a student as you, a research scholar or your teacher or a nation continue to fulfill the dream with calculated risk. Anything which we start, PDS we started 2000 universities, maybe with a risk whether this much money is to be spent or not. But if the result is obvious, ROI is clear from the evaluation, definitely that is going to be the model which the country will take forward. So these are some of the National Mission for Teachers Education Scheme for Higher Education Youth Appreciation and Skill, SREYAS, a project which is started Distant Education Bureau, which I mentioned. Autonomous colleges, now it is starting under AIU, and plagiarism detection software is the latest, which ministry has communicated to all vice chancellor, UGC secretary has communicated, director has reached. So our outreach was to a minimum level, but this time this is the first project in InfliNet, perhaps in the country, which is going to 1000 plus universities and institutions together. That means higher education is treated not like a separate central university or private deemed university. Some of the things which we should take in totality so that the quality will be improved. And our outreach is to, with all this initiative, many of the thing in open access content is available to all. And this is the concluding slide, which I started with a tree, then I am ending with that, what are the major focus of our project here on that, which you can read: Shodh Ganga, Shodh Gangotri, Sol, Soyam, and InfliNet Center. Open data. At the end, I would also request you, you have been listening to InfliNet Center for long, our activities. You are not actually listening to a profile of an institute. You are listening to what should be the future in the higher education. So we invite you to our center in Gandhinagar. What you see in the picture is the building, which is, we moved to the new building in 2013, which is the state of the art IT structure which is having. I can say that we use CAD 7A from inception, which gives 10 gigabytes backbone and 100G roadmap. We expect that another 30 years, the IT infrastructure which we established in InfliNet will be sufficient to meet the requirement of the academician in the country. That is why every project comes in a short while, we execute this project. And we have physical and IT infrastructure. You come there, we have redundancy in data, NKN is connected there. We have Badal and other cloud infrastructure. And welcome to feel the IT. The IT is not information technology. It can be, feel it at InfliNet, how the resources are getting shared. And we also have a work culture, which I cannot put it in slide, which you can understand only if you come to InfliNet. We have the physical training halls, we have guest houses. The InfliNet has received about dozen awards. So few awards are listed. E-India Jury Choice Award for Shodh Ganga, and the Mandan Award, this is for Enlist Digital Enabled ICT Education Award. This is again for Enlist and Shodh Sindhu. Scotch Digital is for Enlist. E-Jury for Shodh Ganga, we received this E-Jury Choice 2 times. And EduSign Excellence Award in this year for the digital initiative, that is for Shodh Ganga, and some of the international award. President's Special Recognition for Scientist and the former director, Dr. Arora, and Open Education Excellence Award in Vidya Mitra, and NTLT Leadership Award for Shodh Ganga from Washington, USA, which has been given by NTLTD as well as USETD. So the model which we do here generally goes to international level. And I end with the most famous slogan of our Honorable Prime Minister, which stand IT plus IT equal to IT. If you are a math student, you will be feeling that why I am not putting 2 IT. This first IT stand for information technology, which InfliNet is based that. That is the where we focus on information technology plus Indian talent equal to India's tomorrow. If you have any query, you can put it in the discussion forum, or you can mail it to us and we will be available. Better address all the query to the ARPIT platform and I will be there to address your queries. Thank you for patiently listening to me. Thank you very much.